Well, Cavaliers come down, talk on this defensive stance. Got your best defenders on the floor in Martin or Allen and Okoro and LeVert.
Rozier tries to shed Okoro. Oh, Okoro fouled him, and Rozier has a chance to tie this game with a four-point play.
We had a normal drift of the leg by the shooter, and the distance covered by the defender is a defensive foul. We have one free throw, and we will play off that.
This season,
no,
Brett.
No, it's not. He's coached his rear end off. I think J.B. Bickerstaff has done an amazing job with this basketball team. I mean, he's had to change his lineup every week to accommodate just whatever he has and gets try to win games.
We are tied at 100. The Cavs had to use a timeout. Whoa, is Niang almost had that ball go off his body as Okoro fed it there. Back it goes to Okoro. I started to say the Cavs have only one timeout left after they had to use one for that coach's challenge. Cavs now are late in the shot clock. LeVert to get inside, and the Cavs run out of time. Whoa, boy.
Pretty good defense by Miami. Got to give them credit. Cavaliers had them, though. Had a little bit of that guy's falling down and going several different ways, and I think we should have attacked a little quicker, but good defense by Miami.
The start of the possession didn't help either with the near turnover.
Sent a scrambling.
Here's Rozier. Off it goes to Butler. He has 10 to shoot. Butler works on LeVert. He'll throw on the brakes. Got tangled up by LeVert. Elevates, fires, and scores. Jimmy Butler gives the Heat a 102-100 lead.
Well, he didn't panic at all. Jimmy Butler didn't. Cavs had him, too. It got him tangled up. Could have got the hands on that basketball. Now you got to come back. Get a good shot. There you go.
Garland. What a pass inside to Allen. Allen dunks. He now has 25 points and 20 rebounds, and we're tied at 102.
Great job by Darius Garland keeping that dribble alive. The defender steps up. He threads the needle. Jarrett Allen's right where he's supposed to be.
Now it's time for a Cavalier stop as this crowd rises to its feet. It is deafening in this building. Rozier picked up by Okoro. He wants to shoot it. He will. Timeout Cavaliers.
Well, that was a heck of a shot, Terry Rozier. You have to figure out a way to get a good clean look at a three.
Garland will find Caris LeVert. LeVert goes baseline. Now he'll give it back to Niang. Niang toward the basket. He will take the two, but now the Cavs have to foul quickly. As Eric Spoelstra will take a timeout, and what he'll do now is advance the basketball into the forecourt. And again, having to go the length of the floor, they cannot afford for any extra seconds to run off this clock as Rozier gets fouled with 2.8 to go.
We throw a full court 69-footer, just like Max Struce's 59-footer, we win this game. Just that easy.
But here's Rozier, 22 points tonight. His first one is good. There's a look at former Heat wing Max Struce. Struce has missed the last handful of games as he is one of the Cavaliers starters dealing with an injury. Max Struce is a big reason why the Heat were able to do what they did last season in the playoffs. Well, here's the second by Rozier. Sam Merrill's in the game, another long-range threat. So now the Cavs, remember, the clock doesn't start until the ball is touched, so they can fire this one down the floor, see if they can get a look here with 2 seconds to go. Niang will throw it into the air. It goes to Allen. He'll dump off to Garland. Garland double clutches! And this one is over. The Miami Heat come to town and beat the Cavs by the final of 107-104.